Hi, today I'm going to talk to you about the value of a second opinion for an IVF patient. I'm Dr. Malpani. I'm an IVF specialist at www.drmalpani.com and in our clinic, Malpani Clinic in Colaba in Mumbai. I've been doing IVF for many years now, over 30. And in fact, we were one of the first IVF clinics in India. And because we've been doing IVF for so long, we've seen lots of patients through the years, especially patients who failed IVF cycles in other clinics and who are now coming to us for a second opinion. Did the first doctor do a good job or not? Did he treat me correctly? Should I go back to him for a second IVF cycle? Can you do something differently? Lots of questions which a lot of patients have. And that's why I'm going to talk to you today about what you need to do to make sure that you get a second opinion correctly, effectively, and efficiently. A lot of IVF patients are actually very scared to ask for a second opinion. And partly because they are worried that if they get a second opinion, their first IVF doctor will take offense and say, "What? You don't trust me? I'm the expert. I've taken such good care of you. Why don't you just do everything I tell you? Why do you need to spend time and energy and money getting a second opinion? Aren't I good enough for you?" And because they don't want to offend that doctor, they're very reluctant to either get a second opinion, or even if they do get a second opinion, they often do it behind that IVF doctor's back, which is obviously not very good because they often don't have all the medical records they need to get an intelligent second opinion. The truth is that every good IVF doctor is happy when you get a second opinion. And in fact, the good IVF doctors will refer you to a second IVF doctor if you want a second opinion, because they know that all good doctors are going to say exactly the same thing. And if you as a patient hear exactly the same thing from a second IVF doctor, that's just going to increase your confidence levels in the first. So there's no reason to be scared. Now, the good news is there are lots of ways of getting a second opinion. But I strongly believe that even before you go for your first consultation with an IVF doctor, you should actually get your second opinion. Let me explain to you how and why. In one sense, if you do your research and homework by finding out as much as you can about IVF, what's involved, what questions a good IVF patient asks, what answers a good IVF doctor gives. So if you've done all this before, in one sense, your first consultation with any IVF doctor will actually be a second, because you already know what questions to ask, what answers to expect, so that you'll then be in a better position to judge whether this doctor is telling you the right stuff or not. And that's why we encourage you to check out the wealth of information we have, which is written purely for IVF patients like you. I can assure you this information is reliable, it's updated, it's authentic, it's stripped of jargon, and it's because I have written this information. We have over 100 videos, thousands of pages. Our website is www.drmalpani.com. And the best thing is this information is free, so what do you have to lose? So again, do your homework first, then go check out the doctor, do the consultation, and then don't be scared about asking for a second opinion, but please be well organized when you go in for your second opinion. Get all your medical records, summarize them in chronological order, continue doing all your homework, so that when you then go for your second opinion, your questions are very laser focused. And if you ask good questions, trust me, the doctor will respect you a lot more and will be able to give you a far more intelligent second opinion. One way of getting a second opinion is to take your file and actually do a face-to-face consultation, and that's a great thing to do. But don't hide information. Don't hide information from your second opinion doctor. Don't try to play games. The more you tell him what happened in your first cycle, for example, or what your first doctor said, the better he'll be able to tell you. It's perfectly okay for you to ask questions like, "Why did my first doctor say this?" Now, obviously, that poor second opinion doctor can't be a mind reader and know what happened in the mind of the first doctor, but at least he can tell you why he's providing you with a certain degree of advice, and he can provide you with well-reasoned options, and you will be able to ask much better questions because you're going in for a second opinion. Please check out our website, and if you still have more questions, feel free to send me an email and I'll be happy to give you a second opinion completely free of cost. And the great thing is that way you're sure that you're getting the right quality of medical care, the best possible medical care. Because the reality is, doctors can't be mind readers. However good we are at providing you with high-tech, high-touch medical care, we don't know whether you'd rather try with your own eggs or donor eggs. All we can do is share information with you. But you need to tell us what's happening in your mind, what your personal preferences are so we can factor these in when we are crafting a treatment plan for you. Please check out www.drmalpani.com, and if the second opinion I provide you helps you to have a baby, nothing will give me more pleasure, because that's the reason I became an IVF specialist, to help infertile couples to complete their family. See you.